Hi there. So my name is Brad Dragon. I'm a tunnel agent with the team SES, and we're at the VRCV crossover box today just for a bit of a site walk to go and see Anne, our second TBM on the Northolt Tunnel's east, and the fourth TBM on the Northolt Tunnel's line. So we're at the bottom of the Victoria Road crossover box. This is where the two TBMs, Emily and Anne, were launched from. They're now well on their journey. We're about between 500 metres and a kilometre along our section of the drive. We'll be walking in to go to the upline TBM. This section that we're in now is the SCL, or the shotcrete lined section of tunnel, or a mined tunnel. We brought the TBMs into here to be launched and assembled. And here you can see the start of the TBM rings. This is the first permanent ring that was installed at launch, and these transfer rails are also part of the temporary works that was used to launch the machines. In the top you can see we've got the ventilation, the tunnel ventilation. This runs all the way down to the TBM in the top of the tunnel and is extended from the machine. Equally, this conveyor belt that you can see is used to bring the excavated material out off of the TBM up to the surface and then onto train. In the tunnel segment line that you can see here, these rings are produced in Hartlepool in the segment factory up there, and then transported by train down to site to be installed. We're on the backup gantry, the last backup gantry currently, on the way to the forward to the ring build area and the TBM operators, and we'll see the machine in all its glory. Today we're on ring 228. And we're roughly 10% the way towards heading west towards Green Park Way, where the West Ruislip Northolt Tunnel's west machines are digging towards us, and we meet at Green Park Way. So we're well on track in the second machine to meet our meeting point. We're in the TBM ring build area. They've just finished a ring build not long ago, and we're currently doing an excavation, a cut. So once the machine has pushed forward about 1.9 metres, we'll have enough space here to assemble our next ring. From this erector area and erector platform, the ring builders have a control where they control the vacuum erector, and from there they pick up segments at ground level and they can maneuver around and install the segments in and around the ring and to install a complete ring. Once the segment is built from one to another, they install these segment bolts to hold them together, which are taken off later on at the back of the machine. As you can see, it's a bit of a confined space, so it's, you know, a tight and hot and warm environment, but they average about 5 to 8 rings per shift. It's a constant work, and yeah, it's hard work up here.
Hi, my name's Rob Morgan, and I'm the agent for the Victoria Road Ancillary Shaft, which is where we are now. We're here in West London in the 25 metre diameter and 25 metre deep shaft that TBM Emily was launched from. Now, this shaft we started building in 2021, and we sunk with 11 precast segments, 11 rows of precast segments, and then a big spray concrete lining shaft down to about 30 metres with a big thick 7 metre thick base slab. Now we're at a stage where the TBM has been launched, and as a civils team, we're back in the shaft and we're constructing a cross passage to connect to the other TBM line, and then a concrete core. This shaft, 2/3 of it will remain fully open throughout its design life for natural ventilation. So as trains move through the shaft at about 140 kilometers an hour, they'll suck fresh air in to naturally ventilate the tunnels. Above the shaft, there'll be a head house. So it'll sit over 1/3 of the northern half of the shaft and has a lot of rooms with mechanical and electrical equipment, big transformers, big bits of switchgear to support those tunnel services. Between here and West Ruislip portal, there are 4 further shafts. Each of those shafts also has a concrete internal core structure and a head house, providing tunnel ventilation and mechanical and electrical services to the tunnels below. We're now at Westgate vent shaft, which is the first shaft on the route that TBM's Emily and Anne will drive through. We're about 2 kilometres further west on the route, and we're parallel to the London Underground Central Line and the A40 in the London Borough of Ealing. As you can see behind me, the headhouse construction is ongoing, and there's now a capping slab over the shaft. This shaft has forced ventilation, which means it has two large tunnel ventilation fans which draw air in through those two large chimneys and force air into the tunnels to drive out smoke in an emergency fire or to improve the environment conditions during maintenance operations. The next phase of works is the completion of the reinforced concrete for the headhouse, and then we move into architectural fit out, which is blockwork, brickwork, cladding, and then also mechanical and electrical work, so all of the cabling and ductwork to support the high-speed rail systems. It'll also have a green roof. We're here at South Ruislip vent shaft, and we're stood on basement level 2 of the main shaft. This is the first shaft on the route from West Ruislip portal, where TBM's Caroline and Sushila were launched, and the TBM's passed through here recently. South Ruislip is twin shafts, and we're stood in the 20 metre diameter main shaft, and just across from me is the 12.5 metre diameter satellite shaft. South Ruislip is one of the most advanced shafts on the Northolt tunnels, and we're heading into the next phase of works, which is going to be mechanical and electrical fit out and constructing the steel frame for the headhouse. The next shaft that we come to is Mandeville Road. Mandeville Road is also twin shafts, but a really challenging construction site because Mandeville Road is constructed in the side of a network rail embankment. So before the team at Mandeville could start sinking the shaft, they first had to do a lot of ground stabilisation, including fissure grouting and installation of 2 sheet pile walls, before they could then form a site to start sinking the main shaft, which is 20 metres in diameter, and then the satellite shaft, which bellies out underneath the tracks as well. Due to the challenges with stabilising the embankment and getting started with the shaft, Mandeville has just completed its excavation and is now done waterproofing and into secondary lining. We're now stood on the TID slab in the main shaft at Mandeville Road. TID stands for Tunnel Isolation Damper, and this 2 metre slab is about halfway down the shaft. Below me is 16 metres of foam concrete, which is lightweight concrete that TBM Caroline is going to drive through shortly. Once that drive is complete and the TBM has passed the shaft, the team here will break out the foam concrete and connect the shaft into the TBM tunnel. Behind me, you can also see the maintenance adit. So the maintenance adit connects the main shaft to the satellite shaft and also allows people to access across. The satellite shaft will purely be used as a ventilation duct for air to get down into the other TBM tunnel, where TBM Sushila is currently parked within the satellite shaft. This is Green Park Way vent shaft. This is the twin shaft site where the TBMs will break through. The shafts here are going through their waterproofing stage. So the main shaft has just completed waterproofing and is starting the secondary lining, getting it ready to receive the tunnel boring machines. So all 4 TBMs will be extracted out the ground here. That's TBMs Caroline and Sushila breaking through towards the end of this year, and then TBMs Emily and Anne breaking through at some point in 2025.